So time response of the first order control system. So this is the basic block diagram of the first order control system. So I just take down transfer function of this block diagram. So the transfer function of the, this this block diagram C of S by R of S, which is equal to, so 1 by TS by 1 plus TS 1 by TS into 1. So this is the negative feedback. So negative feedback transfer function formula. So G of S by 1 plus G of S into H of S. Based on this formula, I just wrote this. And so 1 by TS by, so here T of S is LCM. So TS is TS plus 1 by TS. So here TS plus cancel, 1 by TS plus 1. So here T is nothing but time constant of the system. And so C of S by R of S is equal to 1 by ST plus 1. So here C of S is equal to, so R of S into 1 by ST plus 1. So I just take down input as R of T is equal to 1. So R of T is equal to 1. So for step input, R of T is equal to 1. So now Laplace of the R of T is equal to R of S is equal to 1 by S. R of S is equal to 1 by S. I just substitute R of S value in this. This is equation 1. Substitute R of S value in equation 1. And now I will get CFS is equal to 1 by S, CFS is equal to 1 by S into 1 by ST plus 1, 1 by ST plus 1. Now I just use it here, use fraction and C of S, which is equal to 1 by S by 1 by ST plus 1, which is equal to partial fraction apply chaste. So instead of using partial fraction, A by S B by ST plus 1. So like partial fraction here. So equation 2. So just write down A is equal to limit S tends to 0. S into C of S. S into C of S. So A is equal to limit S tends to 0. S into, so here C of S is equal to S into 1 by ST plus 1. S plus 1 by ST plus 1. Here S and cancel. So now I will get limit S tends to 0 1 by ST plus 1. 1 by ST plus 1. Just substitute S value 0 here. So it means that 1 by 1. So I will get 1. So here A value is 1. A value is 1. Now I just want to find out B value. So how I will take limit S tends to 0. So here S tends to 0 means that, so here this is in denominator term S is equal to, so S is equal to 0. So that's why I just apply S tends to 0. Next here I want to find out a B term. So here B by S plus ST plus 1. So means that st plus 1 is equal to 0, so st is equal to minus 1 and t is equal to minus 1 by s. So here I'm applying limit s tends to minus 1 by s. 1 by, sorry, here s is equal to 1 by t. S is equal to 1 by t. So s tends to minus 1 by t. Just want to find out the value. So here b is equal to s tends to minus 1 by t, s tends to minus 1 by t, st plus 1, c of s, which is equal to s tends to minus 1 by t, st plus 1, st plus 1, into c of s. So the value of c of s, we already know that 1 by s into 1 by st plus 1. So here 1 by st plus 1, 1 by st plus 1 cancelled. So here I will get 1 by, so substitute s value here, minus 1 by t, 1 by minus 1 by t, means that 1 by 1 into t by 1. So this seems that b is equal to minus t, b is equal to minus t. So now substitute a and b values in equation 2. Substitute a and b values in equation 2. Substitute a and b values in equation 2. So in order to find that, as c of s is equal to 1 by s, so here a value is 1 by s, and plus, so plus into minus minus, so that's why I just write down here minus. So what is the value of b is minus t, so substitute b, st plus 1, st plus 1. So here c of s is equal to 1 by s minus 1 by s plus 1 by t, s plus 1 by t. So here I just take down b as the exam, so numerator by t and denominator by t, so I will get this. So now I just apply inverse Laplace transform of this. So c of t is equal to 1 minus 1 by s means that 1. And so 1 by s plus 1 by t, it seems that, so e to the power of minus t by t, e to the power of minus t by t. This is equation 3, c of t value. Now we'll find different time responses in first order, so different time responses. At t is equal to capital T, at t is equal to capital T, and t is equal to capital T, I just substitute here c of capital T is equal to 1 minus e to the power of, so t is equal to capital T means that minus t by t, minus t by t. So here t cancelled. So I will get 1 minus e to the power of minus 1. is nothing but 1 minus 1 by e. So with help of calculator, so we calculate 1 minus 1 by e value is 0.63. So 0.63 approximately. So 0.63. Now at t is equal to 2t, at t is equal to 2t, so I just take down c of 2t is equal to 1 minus e to the power of minus 2t by t. So your pt cancel, so pt cancel, 1 minus e to the power of minus 2, 1 minus 1 by e square, 1 minus 1 by e square, and so which is nothing but c of 2t is equal to 1 minus 1 by e square, the value is 0.86. The value is 0.86. Next step. At t is equal to 3t, at t is equal to 3t, c of 3t, which is equal to 1 minus e to the power of, 1 minus e to the power of minus 3t by t. So here pt cancel, so 1 minus e to the power of minus 3. Seems that 1 minus 1 by e cube, the value of this is 0.95. So 0.95. Same as well as t is equal to 40, t is equal to 40, c of 40, which is equal to 1 minus e to the power of minus 40. Minus 40 by t. So we have t cancel. This is the number 1 by e to the power of 4. The value is so around 0.9817. T is equal to 5t, at t is equal to 5t, c of 5t, which is equal to 1 minus e to the power of minus 5t by t, minus e to the power of minus 5t by t. So we have pt cancel. So this is nothing but 1 minus e to the power of minus 5. And then we can write down 1 by e to the power of 5. So it is nothing but 0.99. So c of 5t value. So up to what value we can find it, sir? So up to how many values we should find like this? So when we observe clearly the starting of the time signal, we get 0.63. Then the next value is 0.86, and the next value is 0.95, and the next value is 0.98, and the next value is 0.99. So, in order to get, means that when we take a step signal as the input, the output of the steady state response, is trying to reach, so here this is called a transient response, the input. So here this is 0.99. Mean that almost reach 1. So in steady state response is almost reach the 1. So whenever the value is infinity, so here t is equal to infinity of t. So we'll get 1. So definitely. So c of infinity t is equal to 1 minus e to the power of minus minus infinity. Minus infinity d by d. So here dt cancel. So we put I minus 1 by power of infinity. Since that 1, the value is 0. 0 is 1. So I will get it is equal to the 1. So that's why the t value is taken, t tends to infinity in the find the steady state error. So in the time we'll discuss this. So this is time response of first order control system. So time response of the first order control system. So with help of graphical representation, show clearly. And this is C of t, and this is t. Okay, minus t to t time responses 3t and 4t, 5t, and so on up to infinity t. Infinity t. So, for example, this is my input. So 1 hour I will take down t value. So here I just get 0.63, which is another 63%. So this is my 1 value. So I just this is 0.5. It's approximately here. Get the value approximately here. The t value. And 2t is 86%, and 3t is 0.95%, and 4t is 98%, and so 5t is 99%, 5t is 99%, 4t is 95, 3t is 86. So, the help of graph will be drawn like this. Graph is 63%, and OT is 86%, and OT is 95%, 99%. So easy to generate purpose. So we'll take step signal as the input of the control system. So step signal is easy to generate. So that's why the step signals are taken input of the control system. This is time response of the first order control system. Any doubts, ma'am, in this?